Cyril M. Kornbluth. Cyril M. Kornbluth, July 2, 1923, March 21, 1958, was an American science fiction author and a member of the Futurians. He used a variety of pen names, including Cecil Corwin, S. D. Gottesman, Edward J. Bellin, Kenneth Falconer, Walter C. Davis, Simon Eisner, Jordan Park, Arthur Cooke, Paul Dennis Lavond, and Scott Mariner. The M. in Kornbluth's name may have been in tribute to his wife, Mary Byers. Kornbluth's colleague and collaborator Frederik Pohl confirmed Kornbluth's lack of any actual middle name in at least one interview. Kornbluth was born and grew up in the uptown Manhattan neighborhood of Inwood, in New York City. He was of Polish-Jewish descent, the son of a second-generation, American, Jew who ran his own tailor shop. According to his widow, Kornbluth was a precocious child, learning to read by the age of 3 and writing his own stories by the time he was 7. He graduated from high school at 13, received a CCNY scholarship at 14, and was thrown out for leading a student strike before graduating. As a teenager, he became a member of the Futurians, an influential group of science fiction fans and writers. While a member of the Futurians, he met and became friends with Frederik Pohl, Donald A. Wolheim, Robert A. W. Lowndes, and his future wife Mary Byers. He also participated in the Fantasy Amateur Press Association. Kornbluth served in the U.S. Army during World War II, European theater. He received a Bronze Star for his service in the Battle of the Bulge, where he served as a member of a heavy machine gun crew. Upon his discharge, he returned to finish his education, which had been interrupted by the war, at the University of Chicago. While living in Chicago, he also worked at Transradio Press, a newswire service. In 1951, he started writing full-time, returning to the East Coast, where he collaborated on novels with his old Futurian friends Frederik Pohl and Judith Merrill. Kornbluth began writing at 15. His first solo story, The Rocket of 1955, was published in Richard Wilson's Fanzine Escape, Volume 1, Number 2, August 1939. His first collaboration, Stepsons of Mars, written with Richard Wilson and published under the name Ivar Towers, appeared in the April 1940 Astonishing. His other short fiction includes The Little Black Bag, The Marching Morons, The Altar at Midnight, Miss Found in a Chinese Fortune Cookie, Gomez and the Advent on Channel 12. The Little Black Bag was first adapted for television live on the television show Tales of Tomorrow on May 30, 1952. It was later adapted for television by the BBC in 1969 for its Out of the Unknown series. In 1970, the same story was adapted by Rod Serling for an episode of his Night Gallery series. This dramatization starred Burgess Meredith as the alcoholic Dr. William Fall, who had long lost his doctor's license and become a homeless alcoholic. He finds a bag containing advanced medical technology from the future, 2098, which, after an unsuccessful attempt upon it, he uses benevolently. The Marching Morons is a look at a far future in which the world's population consists of 5 billion idiots and a few million geniuses, the precarious minority of the elite working desperately to keep things running behind the scenes. In his introduction to The Best of C.M. Kornbluth, Pohl states that The Marching Morons is a direct sequel to The Little Black Bag. It is easy to miss this, as Bag is set in the contemporary present while Morons takes place several centuries from now, and there is no character who appears in both stories. The titular black bag in the first story is actually an artifact from the time period of the Marching Morons, a medical kit filled with self-driven instruments enabling a far future moron to play doctor. A future Earth similar to the Marching Morons, a civilization of morons protected by a small minority of hidden geniuses, is used again in the final stage of Kornbluth and Pohl Search the Sky. Miss Found in a Chinese Fortune Cookie, 1957. Is supposedly written by Kornbluth using notes by Cecil Corwin, who has been declared insane and incarcerated, and who smuggles out in fortune cookies the ultimate secret of life. This bait is said to be Kornbluth's response to the unauthorized publication of Mask of Demeter, as by Corwin and Martin Pearson, Donald A. Wolheim, in Wolheim's Anthology Prize Science Fiction in 1953. Biographer Mark Rich describes the 1958 story Two Dooms as one of several stories which are concerned with the ethics of theoretical science and which explore moral quandaries of the atomic age. Many of Kornbluth's novels were written as collaborations, either with Judith Merrill, using the pseudonym Cyril Judd, or with Frederik Pohl. These include Gladiator at Law and The Space Merchants. The space merchants contributed significantly to the maturing into the wider academic respectability of the science fiction genre, not only in America but also in Europe. Kornbluth also wrote several novels under his own name, including The Syndic and Not This August. Kornbluth died at age 34 in Levittown, New York. Scheduled to meet with Bob Mills in New York City to interview for the position of editor of the magazine of fantasy and science fiction, Kornbluth had to shovel snow from his driveway, which delayed him. Running to meet his train, he suffered a fatal heart attack in the platform of the station. A number of short stories remained unfinished at Kornbluth's death. These were eventually completed and published by Pohl. One of these stories, The Meeting, the magazine of fantasy and science fiction, November 1972, was the co-winner of the 1973 Hugo Award for Best Short Story. It tied with Ariel Afrodi's Urema's Dam. Almost all of Kornbluth's solo SF stories have been collected as his share of glory, The Complete Short Science Fiction of C.M. Kornbluth, Nesva Press, 1997. Frederik Pohl, in his autobiography The Way the Future Was, Damon Knight, in his memoir The Futurians, and Isaac Asimov, in his memoirs In Memory Yet Green and I Asimov, a memoir, all give descriptions of Kornbluth as a man of odd personal habits and eccentricities. Kornbluth, for example, decided to educate himself by reading his way through an entire encyclopedia from A to Z. In the course of this effort, he acquired a great deal of esoteric knowledge that found its way into his stories, in alphabetical order by subject. When Kornbluth wrote a story that mentioned ballista, an ancient Roman weapon, Pohl knew that Kornbluth had finished the A's and had started on the B's. According to Pohl, Kornbluth never brushed his teeth, and they were literally green. Deeply embarrassed by this, Kornbluth developed the habit of holding his hand in front of his mouth when speaking. Kornbluth disliked black coffee, but felt obliged to acquire a taste for it because he believed that professional authors were supposed to drink black coffee. He trained himself by putting gradually less cream into each cup of coffee he drank, until he eventually weaned himself, Knight's description, and switched to black coffee. Spider Robinson praised this collection, saying, "I haven't enjoyed a book so much in years." Mark Rich wrote, "Critics judging Kornbluth by this anthology, edited by Pohl, have seen a growing bitterness in his later stories. This reflects editorial choice more than reality, because Kornbluth also wrote delightful humor in his last years, in stories not collected here. These tales demonstrate Kornbluth's effective use of everyday individuals from a variety of ethnic backgrounds as well as his well-tuned ear for dialect." Kornbluth's name is mentioned in Lemony Snicket's series of unfortunate events as a member of VFD, a secret organization dedicated to the promotion of literacy, classical learning, and crime prevention. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.